So, as you guys could just see, that was 43133 and something else on the front, bound for a service bound for London Paddington from Swansea. And hello everyone, welcome to the latest video from KTV, and today we're at Didcot Parkway, again on the Great Western Main Line. It's my second visit, second consecutive visit to the Great Western Main Line. Got Tornado922 here, but yeah, so that's going to be good. Also pulling in, oh by the way, that train was the one that brought me in from Bristol Parkway. And that one there is 165 something 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 from London Paddington going to Oxford. And I believe over there is another one going to London Paddington from Oxford. And there's 66201 looking pretty over there. So, yeah, enjoy the video. I should basically point out the main facts as well. You'll be seeing services from Great Western Railway and also cross country along the Didcot North Junction over here, or the Didcot East Junction, I'm not too sure which one it is. Or it's the junction, anyway, that leads over to Oxford, the ones that avoid. Also, they will be serving destinations including London Paddington, Oxford, Swansea, Bristol Temple Meads and Cardiff Central. Also, junction will serve services to Oxford, Bournemouth, Newcastle, Reading, Edinburgh, Reading and Worcester Shrub Hill. So, enjoy the video. Please do like and subscribe and all that. Yeah, it's Didcot Parkway. Okay, and the first Didcot Junction station, train, is 220031 with an absolute, with a great two-tone, off to Reading from Edinburgh. And that's 220031. There are a couple of quite a few actually. There's an extended amount of network rail workers down the line, so we're bound to get some good two tones, maybe even more, three tones, four tones, five tones, even, you know, could get loads. But I think usually around the junction they are very good with tones, so yeah, we'll be seeing a lot of that today. So the next train to be coming through is a Deutschbahn Schenker class 66. It is heading for Moulton from Acton, and we also have a Freightliner also slowly making its way through as well. You will see a lot of freight workings here, so that's pretty good. Just slowly tiptoe over here to see 66154. Hauling quite a lot with it. From what I read, apparently it was 600 tons. Oh, that was a lovely two-tone. On the Great Western Main Line, I have quite a few nicknames for train stations. I call Slough, no, I call a lot of the Thames Valley stations, I call them Fast Train Central. I call Oxford Commuter Central. I call Reading GWR Central, along with London Paddington as well. And I call Didcot Parkway Tone Central. And we have another one coming through. It's a one tone, that one. And it is a Freightliner 70016. Whoa! I love that! That was an amazing one! Wow! And we also have a Great Western Railway high speed train coming through. This will be a service bound for Bristol Temple Meads, coming through now as well. It's coming in quite slowly. This one is bound for, oh no, sorry, my mistake. This one is bound for Cardiff Central from London Paddington. Oh, it's got, no it hasn't. 43025 with another brilliant two-tone. And we have another cross-country Voyager passing through as well. 43160, that's for Cardiff Central. And a cross-country Voyager also making its way through as well. Budge out your way there. All right then. Here we go. This one's bound for Newcastle from Southampton Central. 220025. And pretty much the first train we've caught without a two-tone, or any tone at all. Without any tone, that's the first one we've caught. That's brilliant. Yeah. What's going on? Next up, HST from Penzance. .43073 on the end. That was another fantastic two-tone. Thank you from the driver for that one. Off next is Class 165, Great Western Railway service to London Paddington from Oxford. And it's 165134. It's only got two coaches, that's a bit strange. Usually bound to catch a double set there. It's very different. Usually catch them on the branch lines, like to Marlow and Henley on Thames. I guess it's because it's a weekday and and the whole railway network is pretty much abandoned. We've got a return over Deutsche Bahn Schenker again. It's just on its own. I think it's going to be pairing up in a minute. Oh no, it's stopping all the way over there. Okay. Well, that was a bit of a disappointment. It's probably going to be pairing up in a minute anyway. And the next train to pass through on the junction is a Great Western Railway HST to Worcester Shrub Hill from London Paddington. Great tone there. .43130. On the rear, .43042. Service us to Worcester Shrub Hill. .165 passing through in the junction now. Off to London Paddington from Oxford, I believe. Am I correct, or is it not going to show up? Oh no, it's deciding to go really, really, really slow. And there's Jared just laughing there because he didn't film it, and now I'm wasting my time on the camera filming it. It is over there, if you guys can see it. That is from Oxford, and apparently they think that that's a railway station over there. It's not. Oh! It's a steam engine. Sounds like. Or is that just the 165 on a funny turn? Doesn't look like anything at the moment. Well, we've got a 165 going really slow here. We've got a Freightliner also coming through. Got a Deutsche Bahn Schenker behind us. But again, is everything coming through at once? I'm just here for the tones. Oh, there you go, see? And an HST, sounds like. Oh no, I thought it was an HST, but no, it's either the other freight or it is an HST. It's a Deutsche Bahn Schenker, right, okay, I was mistaken. 66541, 165101, and 66103. Pulling up there. Sixty-six-five-one is on its way out. With it. There we go, see the rear end of it now. And from what it looks like, we have another Great Western Railway HST on our hands, headed for Bristol Temple Meads as well. We'll be seeing that one in just a second. And the next train to show up is going to be another Great Western Railway Cast Water 3 HST. This one bound for Bristol Temple Meads from London Paddington. This is the, if I'm not mistaken, the 1312 departure. So the last HST that came into this platform, we had a really, really cheerful lady who gave us a brilliant two-tone. This HST, we had a very grumpy man, he swore at me. How lovely. I love my mini, yes indeed. I have a class 31 arriving in on platform 5 right at the end. Bit of an unexpected arrival. That's something you don't see every day. That's pretty good. And 1312 service to Bristol Temple Meads is on its way out. And there goes Jared, Tornado922, going to check up the numbers of the 31. Either that or he's had enough. That service will go on to call at Swindon, Chippenham, Bath, Spa and Bristol Temple Meads. It's not that long from Paddington to Bristol Temple Meads, about an hour and a half, so it's pretty convenient for those Bristolians. And other people who live in Swindon, Chippenham, Bath as well. And pulling up now, we have a class 16. Oh, it is one of the new GWR. No, again, I got fooled. 166207. Oh, 31452 there. Sounding pretty good, actually. And that's 166207, the one that fooled me, off to Oxford. And the next train to show up is going to be a fast service to Swansea from London Paddington. I didn't catch the numbers on that one, I wasn't paying attention. Oh dear. I was so more interested in hoping that HST would give me a tone. Nope. And we've also got a 165 pulling in over there. Don't know if you can see it. That's bound for London Paddington from Oxford. Yeah, apparently it's going to Ealing Broadway. But it's not, it's going to London Paddington. It's just Didcot says it's Ealing. Don't ask. 165117. Yes, it is. 165117. Good eyesight, me. We have a cross-country Voyager off to Bournemouth showing up now. And again, it's going very slow. And we have a Class 66, another one coming through. Oh no, this is a Super Voyager, it's 221. 221, 120, or 130, sorry. That's bound for Bournemouth. And we have a Deutschbahn Schenker about to pass by, well, we have a 1329 service to London Paddington about to show up as well. It's a 66031. Lovely sound. I think my ears just exploded. And with a two-tone there, if you heard it. Oh, there you go, you heard that one. He's in a good mood. This is a service, it's a Great Western Railway Class 43 HST. And this one is from Cardiff Central to London Paddington. This is the 1329, as the 1315 got cancelled. That was the service for Bristol Temple Meads, that one got cancelled. So now this is the 1329 alternative option for the passengers. This is the 1329. Yeah, just wondering what that tone was then. It's this one going out. Yeah, so this one's off to London Paddington. Just calling it Reading and London Paddington. 43037. And leaving us at the same time, the Deutschbahn Schenker. Okay, whilst we were filming there, the Network Rail test train went past. That is not fair. I hate you, railway. So no Network Rail test train today. Making its departure now, 43037, off to London Paddington from Cardiff Central. Kenny Darren on the front. And 42161 on the rear. Just try and get up there and try and get that. Yeah, there we go. Good shot that. This is a hectic railway station today. I've never seen Didcot like this before. Freight everywhere. I absolutely love it. Better than last time I went here. Okay. And 165117 is off to London Paddington from Oxford. Sorry, my mistake, train announcer. Ealing Broadway. That one's a free car set, so that's a bit better. That one's more like it. Will take forever to get to London Paddington. It's local stopping, that one. And 165 next, Great Western Railway Service to Oxford, 165114. Lovely little 210 as it came in. And a nice smile from the driver as well. Thank you very much for that. Probably enjoying the sunny weather. I know I am. And our first Adelante of the day. I haven't seen one of these in ages. It's 180-102 to London Paddington. Why do these never show up when I film on the Great Western Main Line? It's only on weekdays, I guess. And we've also got another Great Western Railway HST thundering through to Temple Meads. What's three still on it? And 43086. They do go faster. About the same speed as Twyford, so it's 125 here. Gotta be. And now approaching, we have another HST full of tones off to London Paddington from Swansea. This one's going to speed through. Three tone there, brilliant. I saw 43179 on the rear, didn't catch the front, unfortunately. There you go, that one is off to, if you can see it, off to London Paddington from Swansea. And we also have a Tampa machine coming through. Seven to six, 913. And 76911. Didn't see this one coming, but that's cool. And the next train to show up is the 1348 Great Western Railway Service to Oxford from London Paddington. It looks like another 165. It is indeed another 165. It's 165128. Oh, we've 166 coach. Lovely. And at the same time, we've got another 165 coming in to London Paddington from Oxford. This will be the 1349. It's like 165, 138, or it's, no, 136 it looks like, maybe. We'll see. I bet you it's even one of those two. Next train to show up on platform one is the service to Cardiff Central from London Paddington. Oh, it's Harry Patch. 43172. Oh, the Bristol one on the end as well. Bristol 2015, even though it's not 2015 anymore. 44192 on the end. And the next train to come by extremely slowly is 43. No, 43? What am I on? It's a nice one there, 66145 it is. I don't know why it's a 43, I've just got an obsession with HSTs at the moment. And we have something else coming by as well, but I don't know what it is. So that's a Deutschbahn Schenker again. Brakes should do a bit of work, but you know, can't please everyone. And as this DB Schenker is on its way along, we have a cross-country Voyager, or Super Voyager, we'll clarify that in just a second, off to Manchester Piccadilly. Has to be Manchester Piccadilly, it can't be anything else. And if this is 220005, then that train has some serious problems, because it's, according to Jared, the train's been stuck in Reading for ages. But I don't know, we'll find out now. Here it comes. It was a 220, we know it is, but we'll see. Here we go. One, yeah, it's 220. Two 20031. Off to Manchester Piccadilly. It wasn't the 220005, that one must have been cancelled. Next train to show up is going to be a fast service from Bristol Temple Meads to London Paddington. Fantastic two-tone. .43084 and .43131. Next train to show up is going to be the 1403 Great Western Railway service from Cheltenham Spa to London Paddington. 43169. Deutschbound Schenker, and 165108 is off to London Paddington from Oxford. Train to make its appearance pretty slowly, might I add, is a cross-country class 220 Voyager off to Southampton Central from Newcastle. It's probably just pulling up, so the HST can probably go out. The HST is not ready to go yet, so that's a bit strange. Let's just see, won't we? Just gonna pull up and probably let the HST go out. Next train to pass by is going to be another Great Western Railway HST off to Worcester Foregate Street. I don't know if you heard the two-tone there, but it was pretty good. 43028. Along the Voyager, which is still waiting there. 43195 and off goes 43169 off to London Paddington from Charlton Spa. Voyager is still waiting there. Is it broken or is it waiting signal clearance? Most logical solution, what explanation, sorry? Awaiting signal clearance. Next train to show up is going to be 431093. 1419 service to Cheltenham Spa. Oh wow. And guys, that shall be me finishing there. Thank you guys for watching Didcot Parkway, Series 7 Video 7 Part 2. I enjoyed it here. And yeah, that's about it. Please do like and subscribe if you enjoyed. I will get back to any comments. And that Voyager is still there. So my next, okay, now it's gonna go. Brilliant. Okay, let's see it go. That was my train, by the way. I'm gonna wait another hour. So guys, that's me done. See you all on Saturday for Liverpool South Parkway and Liverpool Lime Street. This time I'm definitely going there. I'm not going to interfere and put something else in there, like I did with Twyford and Didcot. Because the Friday I'm in college, so that's not possible. So Liverpool is definitely next, and I can 100% guarantee that. And there's Tornado922 making his mark in my video.
Woohoo!
He's happy with that. Very happy indeed. A bit too happy, if you ask me. So thanks guys for watching. I'll see you all soon. Goodbye.